It's the world's biggest protest. More than 1.2 million people are sitting in border against -1 degree, and more than 200 people died.
It's important, I think, to recognize that these fights are global.
Our voice has been suppressed because the internet at the protest site has been cut for last 2 days. And the reporters who are trying to report on the issues are being taken into custody by the police.
So the action today was about standing in solidarity with young people actually in India who are fighting Adani's business proposals.
I am here actually because I felt that time has come that I have to take one side. So I have felt that the corporates, they are trying to create a new world order. It's just like a new banana republics. They are trying to control the people. Anybody standing against, they are targeting them.
I guess the big focus as well has been the farmers movement and the farmers protests and standing in solidarity with them.
So they are targeting my people in Punjab. More than 200 farmers has died in Punjab and nobody has talked about, because this company, Adani company, is supporting the government. Neither government nor he is allowing anybody to speak up.
Like, if people in India are suffering, I'm suffering. I see that we have a common humanity. You know?
I realized it that the corporate, they are doing it, they are trying to control the people. And the people are standing against them. Because the most of the farmers, no, India, most of India's half of the population is farmers. And my state, almost 90% of people are from farmers. So they are sitting at the process site and I'm reading the news. The very first thing is that the basic, we say the internet is the basic amenity. It has been cut off from last 2 days. They are moving military into that. They are providing iron rods to the police. They are building barricades of cement on the roads. They are digging up the roads. They are surrounding the people. I don't know why. I am really concerned about that. What will happen to them? Where are their human rights are going to be violated or not? Because no news. If any reporter is trying to report on that protest, the police is taking him into the custody. So I'm really concerned. My mind is divided between Australia and back home, and I'm really concerned about my people.
Today is about sharing that common humanity, standing up for what is right and just, and reclaiming our democracy both in India and Australia.